Welcome to the Control-M for Amazon Web Services video. In this video, you will learn how to set up a connection profile for the AWS application plugin and create an AWS job to activate an Amazon Web Service. Many users are moving towards using web services in a cloud environment. Control-M users need the ability to orchestrate workflows in a hybrid environment that includes multi-cloud integration. The Control-M for Amazon Web Services, or AWS Application Plugin, enables you to integrate your workflows with Amazon Web Services. There are two ways you can integrate your Control-M workflows with AWS. You can create a connection profile using the application plugin in Control-M version 19. The Control-M for AWS plugin integrates with Lambda, Batch, and Step Functions web services. Or you can use Application Integrator to create a connection profile and AWS job type to integrate with any Amazon Web Service. In this video, we will use the Control-M for AWS plugin to create a connection profile and create a job for AWS Lambda. First, we'll create and set up the connection profile. In the Control-M Configuration Manager, or CCM, locate the relevant host, right-click Control-M for AWS, and select Connection Profile Management. We'll click Plus to add the connection profile, and we'll call it AWS EU Dev1. In the authentication area, enter the access key, the secret access key, and select the region. Now we'll click Next, and then click Test to make sure that the connection is working. Everything looks good. Let's click Finish. Next, we'll create an AWS job and take a look at the job properties. In the planning domain, we'll drag the AWS job type into a workspace. In the job properties, in the What area, we'll select the connection profile that we created. In the Service field, select the service that you want to connect to. Note that the fields change according to the service that you select. As mentioned earlier, this job should connect to the Lambda service, so we'll select Lambda. In the Function Name field, select the Lambda function that you want to activate. Note that the version is also indicated in the dialog box, and the value is automatically entered in the Version field. In the Payload and Client Context JSON fields, enter the parameters that you want. Click here to expand the dialog box. And last, if you want to add the log to the job's output, make sure this checkbox is selected. Let's order the job. Now we'll go to the monitoring domain to view the job. The job completed successfully. Thank you for watching this video.